Yo. Good morning from New Hampshire. Yeah. Climbing up this hill. But I had an awesome couple of days. So I just took a zero in Rutland. And it was so hard to get started from there. I did my 3 mile day with the lightning storm and all that. And thought I was well rested. But I noticed joints and ankles and knees and all that stuff still hurt. And so I got to Hanover Adventure Tours, which, first off, that place is awesome. Super clean. A lot of people working there. They run a tight ship. If you are in the area of Hanover and you need a place to stay, I would highly recommend that place. Eggs and pancakes in the morning, big screen TV, Netflix, Amazon, Pluto, YouTube TV, all kinds of stuff to watch. Just killer place. But anyway, so I got there 2 days ago, and yesterday morning I got up and it was pouring down rain, and it was supposed to dry up but rain again. And anyway, that morning I just decided, you know what, what's another zero? Maybe I need it. Like I said before, everything happens for a reason. So sure enough, I just took another zero. So that's like two zeros in a zero in 1 week. But I think I needed it because my legs feel so much better today. Yeah, it rained like crazy yesterday morning, then it rained again, and then last night there was a thunderstorm, so it was the perfect day to hide from the weather. Ate a lot of good food, but y'all know that's what I do. Yeah, it's awesome. So anyway, I'm in New Hampshire, and it ain't going to be too bad today or tomorrow. Oh, but that third day, Mount Moosalaki. Jeez, you should see the elevation profile. Maybe I'll take a picture of it and put it on here. But it's like 4,000 or 5,000 foot climb. And yeah, you're not already up there. You climb from like really low straight up. So we'll see how it goes. But anyway, I am so looking forward to the whites. Nice cool temperatures. All the pictures I've seen on Instagram, everybody's wearing coats and gloves. And I'm like, yes, I want some of that. Because that means no sweating like crazy and gnats and bugs. But who knows, may get up there and be like, this sucks, but I don't think so. But you know what I'm going to do, right? I'm going to keep you updated. I've rambled long enough. Talk with you in a bit. Peace. Yo. So, just out here walking along. Beautiful woods out here. The camera makes it look a little light, but it's really dark in here. It's kind of like a little enchanted forest. I'm waiting for a hobbit to come running out. Yeah. But it's probably not going to happen. Anyway, I did see a really short dude in town, but anyway, I was thinking, so there was quite a few people at the hostel last night because of the storm that moved in, and several of them are going slack packing today, and so they got dropped off 20 miles north, and they're going to hike back to the hostel and stay at the hostel again tonight. And I gotta admit, that sounded really tempting. However, I have had opportunities to slack pack before and I've never done it. Am I against slack packing? No. You know why? Because when someone puts on a little day pack and they walk, their feet go the same place mine do. And so they've walked every bit of the trail. They just had a lighter load, which really is kind of smart. But you see what I'm carrying? The whole thing. I haven't slack packed yet, and I'm probably not going to. And the super heavy, just resupplied backpack is probably going with me all the way up Katahdin. You know, people say, you know, well, have you ever, I don't know, went around a bad part in the trail? Well, you cheated. You didn't walk the trail. Or have you, you know, did a road walk when the bridge was closed? Yeah, well, you haven't done the trail. So people could say that, you know what? There's all types of cheating that goes on in the whole journey or whatever. But for me personally, you know, everybody can hike their own hike. I started with a big heavy backpack. And to me, for some weird reason, it may be stupid, but I'm going to carry it the whole way. Maybe just making more work for myself, but I don't know. I'm pretty sure it's a hot topic in the hiking world. Some people are probably against slack packing, and some people are like, I guess like the way I think, heck, it's, you're walking the same miles, why not? But I don't know. I got this little thing called stubborn male syndrome. A lot of guys have it, even though a lot of guys don't admit to it. But anyway, white blazes and full pack for me for the whole trip. So that's the plan. Just thought I'd share. Let's climb this here mountain here. Peace.
Yo, good morning. Stayed at Trapper John shelter last night. And I didn't get in there till about 7:30. Yeah, and at this time of year, it gets dark at 7:30, or close to it, so. Had to cook supper and set up in the dark, and finally got to bed about 10:30, 10, something like that. A fellow named Nat Geo, who was a Southbounder, came in last night. A really cool fella, a super down-to-earth guy. He's Southbound, and he was telling me of all the adventures to come, and I was trying to share a little bit about what was coming up going south. So we had good conversation. Matter of fact, this morning I got up at 5:45, but I slept in till, I didn't sleep in, I just kind of laid in my hammock till about 6:30, and it was awesome. But I was ready about 7:42, 7:43, something like that, and heck, sat around camp for another hour talking, good times. But I'm only doing 12 today, so there's a big mountain in that 12, but it's only 12, so hopefully get to camp a little earlier tonight. Weather's supposed to be nice today. Sun's shining right now, so life is good so far. Yeah, that's about it, I guess. Guess we'll talk with you in a bit. Peace. Yo, about to go up Smart's Mountain, and I've been climbing a good bit. A lot of it's like this rock here. I don't know if you can see it, but on top of that mountain, right there, in the center of your screen is the fire tower, and that's where we're headed. Yep. Peace. Smart's Mountain Fire Tower. Pretty cool. Peace. Good morning from Cube Mountain. Not Rubik's Cube, not Ice Cube, just Cube Mountain. Oh, this is gorgeous. You can't see much because it's white out, but it is so beautiful up here and so serene. Good stuff. It's a beautiful world we live in here, you know. God has truly made some beautiful things. Yep. Had a pretty spiritual morning this morning. It's good stuff. Yeah. Anyway, stayed at Hexacuba Shelter. And it was a hexagon shelter. It's really cool. Probably should have took some pictures of it. That happens sometimes. But anyway, lots of climbs yesterday. Tough climbs. Climbing up this mountain here, and then this is the biggest climb till the shelter. And then tomorrow is Musalaki. Yeah, that's going to be a tough climb. Hopefully the weather's going to be nice. But it'll all work out. And then after that, it's another hostel. That means shower, clean clothes, food, recharge. Yeah. But yeah, this is awesome. Let me let you guys get another look. It's complete white out, but man, so nice. Anyway, talk with you in a bit. Peace. Look at that.